This is Big Mike from 94.3 The Shark, everything that rocks. Today, I'm at Stony Brook University for Media Day. Let's go check in with Coach Chuck Priori and the Seawolves players, see what they have in store for us this season. Big Mike from 94.3 The Shark, everything that rocks. Stony Brook University Media Day, standing by with number 13, Ray Bolden, Captain Stony Brook Seawolves. It's not often that Big Mike is made to feel like Little Mike. I feel like a decimal point standing next to Timon Paris here. Number 71 from the offensive line, standing next to the quarterback, Joe Carbone. With number 6, Tyrese Beverett, standing by with team captain, Stacy Bedell. Do I need a stepladder to get this to you? Coach Chuck Priori. Coach, thank you so much for having us. We really appreciate it. Are you excited about Media Day, or is this just taking you away from the fun on the field?
Well, we appreciate you being here and the support you guys give. So, no, it's a good day. It's a chance to get our program out there to the community.
Ray, how's the offseason gone for you?
For me personally, it's pretty much been the same. You know, I've been here for 3 years. I don't really change my routine. You know, put your head down and work, and you look up and you find yourself in a place you want to be. So pretty much nothing's changed for me. Been the same routine.
Man, what is it like standing next to somebody so short?
I'm used to it. Like, everybody feels short to me, so I'm just used to this.
I think if you saw some people standing next to you, I don't know if they would be too cool, calm, and collected as you came walking down the hallway. You understand? I know how I'm feeling here. Is he shaking? Oh, he's shaking. Joe Carbone. The first question I have to ask you, did you know that there is a very famous character in Goodfellas with the last name Carbone?
I do know that, yes.
Did your friends make fun of you, tell you they're going to find you in the meat truck? How has the offseason been for you?
It's been fun. You know, we got a lot of guys, a lot of seniors that's bringing a lot of leadership. And, you know, we have a lot of guys that are capable of playing this season, so it brings a competitive nature to this team.
I've noticed that you hold many of the, you are in the top 10 for many of the rushing records for Stony Brook University. Is that anything that is on your mind when you're out there playing the game, or is that just gravy?
I've never really looked into the rushing records. That's just a stat that's on the side. I definitely look, my first important goal is the winning with the team. I've never looked into rushing records, and that'll be a good accomplishment to have, though.
I've noticed a lot of the team members have mentioned that the energy is a little bit different this year. Do you feel the same way, and what do you attribute that to?
Of course I feel the same way. You know, these guys put too much work in on the offseason and not, you know, achieve their goals. We've been together since our freshman year. You know, a lot of guys, about 20 guys this year as seniors. So we bring, like I said, a lot of leadership to this team, and we want to feed off on the young guys so they can know how to ropes.
What do you think is your biggest challenge going into an offseason or a preseason to try and drive some of your points home?
Yeah, I mean, when you're dealing with a young kid, maybe a kid that just entered our program or last year they redshirted, it's just to tell them how the system works. And I think our upperclassmen this year have done a great job leadership-wise of taking them through what it's going to be like to be a Stony Brook football player and what you need to do to prepare to be a Stony Brook football player. So I think at the end of the day, I rely a lot on them. And then from my perspective, it's just being in a routine, crossing my T's and dotting my I's, and making sure they understand the schedule.
I see they've donned you with the captain's patch. How important has leadership been to you leading up to this being selected as team captain?
So much that the label wasn't of importance to me. It's just knowing that my teammates and my coaches and everyone on staff sees me in that light. For me, that was a special thing, but like I said, nothing's changed. You know, I approach the game the same way. I talk to my teammates the same way I talked to them before I had this label. So, I mean, it's an honor for sure to be, you know, known as a captain of this football team, but it's all the same.
Quarterback, star of the show. Do you find it easier to play when it's a big moment, or does that give you a little bit of the willies?
You know, my motto this season is to make the moment, so that's what I'm going to treat it. And it's easy when I have great teammates around me and a great offensive line.
Now, offensive line is one of those things that gets a little bit lost as far as, you know, little boys looking for their heroes. Did you have any big influences in professional football as you were growing up on the offensive lines?
Growing up, I don't think anybody wanted to play offensive line, so I guess I wouldn't have any heroes per se. But people that I look to now that I've seen is Trent Williams and Tyron Smith. Those are people I try to idle my game after and stuff like that.
coming out this season, what is it we can look forward to from you and the rest of the offense here with the Seawolves?
I definitely think we're going to be an explosive offense this year. We have a lot coming to the game this year. We made some changes, and I definitely feel like it's going to be a big year for us.
What's a better feeling, scoring a touchdown on a five-yard out pattern just when you're close to the goal line, or burning a guy deep 50 yards down the field?
You know, it depends on the look. If he's in your face, you know, coming at you within those 5 yards and you catch it, you know, it's more so like, you know, I outmanned you. But, you know, a touchdown is a touchdown in my eyes, so they're all pretty special.
Now, I joked a lot with some of the players I spoke to about different snacks. Now, you are from Floral Park. I've had some really great Chinese spots, a lot of nice buffets over there. Have you hit those Chinese buffets as well? Uncle Wok specifically?
Not really, but I would hit the pizza spots around the area, and they have a lot of good pizza spots in the area, so like King Umberto's is really good and stuff like that.
Jersey Mike's or Wawa?
Wawa.
Everybody says Wawa from Jersey. We spoke to a player that was from Texas, talked about steak and ribs.
I don't know if you can tell, but I don't really eat much. So.
Also, the quarterback coming from Connecticut. You know, a lot of those Connecticut boys think that the Connecticut pizza is better than New York pizza. For sure. I don't hang out with many of them, but it's true. Do you have a plan in place when it comes to trying to keep the players fit? Like, do you make them stay away from certain things, certain junk foods or little tidbits and desserts and such?
We're on them pretty good. We have a nutritionist in the department that works with our kids, and we do plan all our meals that we have on campus with them. Certainly, we try to educate them all the time on what's good to put into your body, what's not too good to put in your body. You know, it's not just about gaining weight. It's gaining proper weight. It's not about losing weight. It's losing proper weight. So, yeah, we spend a lot of time on that.
Just one of the many reasons why I was not a Stony Brook Seawolf football player. Now, as you head out there, 94-3 the Shark is the Shark. Stony Brook is the Seawolves. Which wolf do you feed, preparation or intensity?
I definitely have to go with preparation.
Preparation.
I will go preparation.
I'm going to go with a little bit of both.
I feel like as a player, you got to have both. You got to bring both to the game.
All right. He's the first one to come off preparation, but that's why he's so intense, and that's why we love him. Last question for you, Coach. When people listen on 94.3 The Shark, they can hear all the Stony Brook Seawolf action. What should they be looking forward to this season?
I think a team that's really going to bring a different personality to the field. I think a team that's going to be focused, and a team, if we have a bad spot, is not going to dwell on it.
Thank you so much, Coach. Coach Chuck Priori here. Big Mike, 94.3 The Shark, everything that rocks.
Thank you, sir.
Have a good season. Thank you very much for checking out Stony Brook Seawolves Media Day. You can catch all your Seawolves action on 94.3 The Shark, everything that rocks. Best of luck to Coach Priori and the rest of the Seawolves team. We are Seawolves. Now, how do you calculate how many hamburgers and hot dogs to bring? Do you have a general idea of the weight of each player? Multiply that times pi. Ooh, pi.